This is the last time I will ever get to say, now with the weather, here's Paul Higgins.
Oh, thank you so much, Tam. It's been wonderful, and we'll talk about that more in a moment. My last day, and what a day, a horrible day. Grey, damp and cold. It was Melbourne's coldest day in 5 years, in fact. It worked. The clicker worked, but I have this pile of clickers here just in case, you know. Don't want to go out on a bad note. Overnight, the northeast was chilliest as it fell to -1 at Rutherglen and Wangaratta, -4 on top of Mount Buller. Thick cloud across the state made it for a chilly day this early in winter, and we had some drizzle patches in the south, bit of rain in the northwest. It barely made it above 10 degrees across much of the state today. Gabo Island, which is way out east, was mildest with 14. The temperature hardly changed from night to day around Melbourne. 10.1 degrees, our city high at 12.37 and 5.15, and a few other times this afternoon, making it our coldest day in 5 years. Out in the gazebo now, it is 10 degrees. Crunchy lawns in Canberra this morning with a frosty -4. Adelaide had some light rain. The nation's north is enjoying lots of sunny weather, but northern Victoria is underneath this northwest cloud band, while our south is getting thick cloud coming out from a low west of us. We had light winds today underneath the high, but tomorrow this low is going to move closer and that will bring some rain to our northwest. Then over the weekend, a Tasman sea low, which is actually way out there, you can see it there, is going to send us southeasterly winds, which does mean a few showers in our south, but particularly in Gippsland, and we're in for some frosty mornings. Tomorrow sunny in Perth and Brisbane will be mostly sunny, and Canberra partly cloudy. Showers for Sydney and Adelaide, and in Hobart showers in the morning. Back home, some welcome rain is coming away in the Mallee and the Wimmera, at this stage around 2 to 10 millimetres of it. There will also be a shower or two over the rest of the state and scattered showers over Gippsland, snow showers down to 1,300 metres elevation. It'll be cold enough in the morning to name it a double doona night, and then a mostly cloudy day. There's a frost warning tonight for the northeast. On the bay, an easterly wind, 10 to 15 knots. We're in for a drizzly night here in Melbourne, a low of 6 degrees and 14 tomorrow. That's 4 degrees warmer than today, cloudy in the morning. Maybe some fog as well, a mostly cloudy afternoon and a light easterly breeze. On Saturday, partly cloudy and our warmest day in the outlook, 15 degrees and a southeasterly breeze. Sunday, partly cloudy, a possible shower in our northwest, a southwesterly wind in the afternoon, 14. Monday, a possible shower, 13. Tuesday, a shower or two, 13. Then even colder on Wednesday, 12 degrees. And on Thursday, showers and 12 again, Tam.
Thank you, Paul. And yes, in case you missed it, it's a big night here on ABC News Victoria. After nearly 40 years, our beloved Paul Higgins is retiring. He'll join me up here at the news desk in just a moment to say goodbye. But first, let's take a look back at just a few highlights from his long career.
Hi, I'm Paul Higgins and welcome along to Behind the News for today.
Welcome along to our first Behind the News for 1986.
Hi, I'm Paul Higgins.
I'm Paul Higgins and welcome along. Hope you had a good break over Easter and didn't eat too many eggs, like me.
Well, here's to 20 years of Behind the News. May the next 20 years be just as good. This is water, by the way, in case you're worried about it. We're lucky enough to have Andrew Gaze in the studio. Andrew, thanks for taking time out to come into BTN.
So, David, thank you very much for appearing on Behind the News, and I do believe that today it's your birthday.
Mr. Hawke, welcome along to Behind the News.
Thanks very much, Paul.
We've just seen the students at Raynella East Primary School presenting you with a petition, which was about the Amazonian rainforests. How do you feel about that?
Well, no doubt you recognise that building behind me. It's our new Parliament House.
Well, the tax has also gone up on wine and on cigarettes.
So pay TV has finally arrived. These are the top 15 cable TV shows for the week.
We'll see you again tomorrow night with all the latest TV news on TV TV.
And now tonight, with the weather, we welcome Paul Higgins.
Thank you very much, Mary. It's great to be with you. And I just got to make sure my tyre's straight here.
Well, the weather now, and it's a while since we've used the word warm, Paul.
That's right, Ian, but what a beautiful word it is.
Now with the weather, here's Paul Higgins.
Thanks, Tam. A few showers coming up for polling day tomorrow, but Sunday is looking good. And that's not a political statement, by the way.
Who should walk past but Mr. Paul Higgins, sometime weather presenter.
Michael Rowland,
very familiar face to breakfast.
Hang around a street corner like this, Michael, for too long. You can get arrested for that. So
bonjour.
Some excellent moments there, Paul. That moustache, what
Look,
a winner.
Got, sort of got one.
It's been such a pleasure and a privilege to work with you, to share a newsroom with you and a studio over the years. And, of course, I grew up watching you on BTN, so I was a fan even before I was lucky enough to become a colleague. And I know how sad our audience will be feeling out there tonight watching this.
Sure.
You are going to be so deeply missed, Paul.
Oh, thank you very much, Tam. And, look, you've been wonderful to work with. I've enjoyed our time together so much. And look, it's been so lovely. I'd like to thank you as well for being such a wonderful colleague. Of course, I've been overwhelmed by the lovely messages, thoughts and wishes I've received over the last week, and so grateful to have been given the opportunity to guide everyone through the weather and the news over a long innings. I'm honoured to have worked with so many talented, fearless and wonderful colleagues over the years, and to those of you at home, I feel so privileged that you've welcomed me into your place each night for all these years. It's very humbling. Be well, take care of yourself and those around you, of course, and thank you.
Oh, thank you, really.